Okay, we're going to go over how to divide polynomials using long division. You would need to use long division when the denominator, in this case 6x plus 1, is not just a monomial, but a binomial or a trinomial, etc. So first of all, make sure you resist the urge to try to cancel the way it is right now. You cannot cancel the 6 into the 12 or the x into the x or the x over the x squared because this is one big factor, the 6x plus 1. And you can only cancel if the numerator was factored and there was another complete factor that looked exactly the same, 6x plus 1. We'll be doing that in another section where if the top was factored and the bottom was factored and there was the exact same factor, you'd be able to cancel. But for now, you have to think of the numerator as this big thing, 12x squared minus 64x minus 11, and the denominator, 6x plus 1. So in order to do this, we're going to have to use long division. And so the denominator is what goes out in front. So this is like a 6x plus 1. And we're dividing that into 12x squared minus 64x minus 11. To be quite honest, it's actually easier to do long division in algebra than with numbers. Most people, once they understand how to do it with algebra, it's a little bit easier. There's no guesswork when you're dividing something like 358 into, 9,670,362. That's difficult. This actually is going to be a little bit easier. And there's a couple ways you might show your work. So I'm going to start off saying, how are we going to start? The main thing I want you to do is you really want to, when you're deciding what to divide into, you're going to pay attention first to the first term here outside, which is 6x. And then I also want to make sure that you write the number underneath this division bar in descending order. So you have your x squared term and then your x and then your constant. Just like when we write 139, we put the 1, then the 3, then the 9. There's an order. The 100's place, the 10's place, and the 1's place. So what you could think of is 6x times what will give you 12x squared. So think about that. What could you multiply 6x times to get a 12x squared? Now, most people could probably do this in your head, but if not, you could actually write down over on the side 12x squared divided by 6x and do the division to get the answer. And in this case, this is 2x. Most people can figure out it's 6x times 2x that will give you exactly 12x squared. That's the procedure here. You're going to think of the first term out in front times what will give you the first term here. All right. Now, the problem is you can't just multiply 2x times 6x plus 1, just like in regular long division. You really have to multiply by the whole thing out in front. So you really have to multiply that 2x times 6x plus 1. All right. And again, if it's easier for you, you can write it out over on the side. What's 2x times 6x plus 1? That would give you 12x squared plus 2x. That's what you're going to put underneath here. I'm going to get rid of that line for now. And we're going to say, well, that's 12x squared plus 2x. This stuff I'm writing over on the left-hand side here, this is sort of scratch work if you need it. Most people won't be doing that. Now, the next step usually would be to subtract. I'm going to put my line all the way across, which is a little bit different than it may be shown in the text. So your next step in division is usually to subtract. Well, keep in mind, when you don't have anything in front of this, it really is a plus 12x squared and a plus 2x. I do not want to add. I want to subtract. But when you subtract, remember, that means just change signs. So I can change it to a minus sign. I'm going to just put up on top what I want to change it to. I want it to be a minus sign. Some people might cancel out that plus sign. Some people circle the plus sign or circle the minus sign. You might want to circle the minus sign. Okay, pay attention to that sign. It's the top sign you want to pay attention to. And now we go ahead and do the addition or subtraction as it may be. So I have 12x squared minus 12x squared. This should always cancel and you should just have a zero. Nothing should be here. But be careful here that I've lined up like terms and I have a negative 64x minus 2x. That's going to give negative 66x. And then we simply bring down the next term. Because we're either adding zero or subtracting zero, you're still just going to have the minus 11. The procedure starts all over again. But now, instead of a 12x squared being the first thing, you're going to look and see what you have here for the first thing is negative 66x. So again, you're going to ask yourself, what could you multiply this first term by, the 6x? What do you multiply 6x times to get a negative 66x? All right, and again, if you're not sure, you could say, well, what is negative 66x divided by 6x? And that will give you the answer if you need to figure that out ahead of time. Most people could say, well, it's going to be minus 11. Because a negative 11 times 6x will give you a negative 66x. Okay, I'm going to get rid of this line now. So, next step would be to multiply this negative 11 times the whole thing out in front here. So, negative 11, again, if you want to show it out here, negative 11 times 6x plus 1, well, that's going to be negative 66x. When you multiply it out originally, you should get exactly the same thing as what was above it for the first term. But I also have to do a negative 11 times 1, which is negative 11. All right. Next step is I don't add those together, I have to subtract. So I'm going to have to change signs again. So I'm going to write the opposite sign above and circle it. Pay attention to the sign above. You don't have to circle it, but it is going to be a it's not going to be the minus signs here that you see originally. And what happens here when I add these together? They're, of course, because you made them the same when you subtract them, they're going to cancel out. But here as well, negative 11 plus 11. So there's no remainder at all. You're done. Zero. It went in evenly. So the answer is up here. It doesn't always come out evenly, but in this case it did. The answer, or the quotient, is 2x minus 11. Okay. Now, it's important you check. Well, how do you normally check when you do log division, if you actually check your work? You multiply what you divided by times your quotient. So that means I have to multiply 6x plus 1 times 2x minus 11 and see if I get this 12x squared minus 64x minus 11. So let's do that. The check would be 6x plus 1 times 2x minus 11. Okay. Now, you can either use the FOIL method, box method, smiley face method, etc. So I'm going to do the FOIL method. 6x times 6x is 12x squared. The outer term, 6x times minus 11, is negative 66x. The inner term is plus 2x. And the last term will be minus 11. Adding like terms, we get 12x squared minus 64x minus 11. You go back and check, was that the original? Yes, here it is. See that 12x squared minus 64x minus 11? There it is, same thing. So this checks, that means your answer is correct.